Ladies and gentlemen, now making her way to the octagon, Melissa Croden.
Less than 6 months after coming up just short in the LFA women's bantamweight title fight at LFA 157, Canadian Melissa Croden hopes a move to Texas will get her back on the winning path and running up that hill. Former LFA bantamweight title challenger, she lost via decision to Jacqueline Calvin-Conte in April, who got the call up to the UFC shortly after. Comes in with a 100% finishing rate, 3 knockouts, 1 submission. Tapology's number 2 ranked female fighter in Canada. Now training here with the Blitz Sports MMA team and Haley Cowan as well. But Cub, she came in that fight against Calvin-Conte. What a war that was. 5-round title fight grind, and she showed that she can hang with anyone.
Yeah, definitely. I watched that fight and I was thoroughly impressed. She had heart because she got rocked so many times in a row. And, like, she got hit, dropped again. It was wild. But she battled back and fought all 5 rounds. That's so impressive. And I think she's gonna look back at this tape, right? Obviously she looked back at the tape and she's made the improvements, and I think the move to a new gym is also huge for people. People don't understand that fighters, it gets a little monotonous in gyms, you know, and you got, sure, sometimes you gotta switch things up, and it kind of ignites that fire. And coming off of a loss like that, when you know that the person you lost to went to the UFC and it showed that they're one of the best, that it's not really that big of a loss when you look at it.
Great insight. Croden did say that after her gym fell apart, she had trained with Haley Cowan before and said she is the perfect training partner. I'm moving to Texas.
Her opponent now making her way to the octagon, Katarina Leonard.
Tough alum, Katharina Katlina from Germany, becoming the first German fighter to enter into the LFA Octagon. True international theme here in Dallas, Texas tonight. She's on the Ultimate Fighter Season 28 Cup. That was back in 2018 on Team Whitaker. Lost in her first fight on the show. She comes in as Tapology's number 8 ranked female fighter in the Midwest. She's now training the Elevation Fight Team in Denver, Colorado.
Yeah, she's definitely with a good team. And that's one of the things that she thinks is going to win her this fight is her conditioning. Because I know I was just there recently and I saw how hard they train. They always push conditioning. But for her to do that, she's got to put a little bit more pep in her step. When I watch her tape, she believes her boxing and her conditioning is going to win her the fight, right?
Yes.
But when I see her boxing, she throws really short punches. She doesn't really extend. So, fighting somebody that's a karate style that's very rangy, she's going to have to close that distance and move those feet and be able to get her to the fence. So we'll see how well she's able to do that.
Katlina coming in as the underdog in this one. Let's now check out the numbers for the tail of the tape. Presented by OnlyFans. Lena is 33 years old. Croden is 1 year younger. Croden is the taller fighter by 2 inches. And she is also 1.5 inches longer in the arms. This is an LFA catch weight at 140 pounds. Back inside to Mike Kendall.
Brian. Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds in an LFA women's catch weight at 140 pounds. Brought to you tonight by OnlyFans, where creators earn. And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner. This mixed martial artist stands 5'9", weighed in 139.4 pounds. She holds a professional record, 4 wins, 2 defeats, with 3 wins coming by way of knockout, 1 by way of submission. Representing Blitzsport MMA and fighting out of Waco, Texas, by way of Calgary, Alberta, Canada, Melissa Scotten-Crowden. Her opponent across the octagon, fighting out of the red corner, is a mixed martial artist standing 5'7", weighing in 140 pounds. She holds a professional record, 8 wins, 4 defeats, with 1 win coming by way of knockout. Representing Elevation Fight Team and fighting out of Denver, Colorado, by way of Schwandorf, Bavaria, Germany, the German Gypsy, Katarina Lehner. Your referee, Steve Armstrong.
Okay, ladies, you received instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Obey my commands at all times. Touch gloves and good luck.
LFA catchweight division. Kat Lehner making her LFA debut tonight. Said she was honored, and even in Germany, they know about the LFA. Melissa Crowden looking to bounce back after her title fight loss. Ron Kruk and Cub Swanson with you for Legacy Fighting Alliance number 169.
Yeah, right away I'm noticing that Crowden is not bouncing as much on her feet like a karate fighter. It looks like she's a little bit more settled in. She did say she was working her head movement, but it looks like she's got a little bit more of a boxing style. We'll see how that works out for her.
Crowden told us that she has been a fan of Kat Lehner since she was on The Ultimate Fighter. Her plan is to stick and move, push her back and press forward. Well, Lehner told us her striking is better. She envisions a knockout with her hands.
Yeah, like I said, I think Kat's going to need to keep pressing forward and try to get her to the fence and use that conditioning that you believe in. Make her fight a tough fight. I think just staying and trading on the outside is going to favor Crowden.
I agree. Crowden, the brown belt in BJJ, but strong taekwondo background as well, and now pushing Kat Lehner up against the octagon wall.
Yeah, usually when someone's a little taller and they got that tie clinch, it's really hard to get them off. When they get it, I tend to wait for them to throw a knee and try to duck out underneath, but you run the risk of getting knee in the face. Crowden's doing a real good job right now with head position. Oh, and Kat's switching it.
Ooh.
That's the battle that people don't see, is that head position is very important.
Can hear the Elevation Fight Team yelling to Kat Lehner, get off the octagon wall. Coming up on the midway point here, opening round, Lehner and Crowden. Good knees now from the Canadian.
Yeah, you can see Kat really struggling with the defense on the tie clinch. So that if I was Crowden, I'd be looking to get to that position more often. Work to get in the clinch and land some knees. Kat's in a good position. She's got the ball, and she just got reversed. Very slick by Melissa.
Crowden looking for her first win here in the LFA. She impressed, though, by surviving in that title fight against Jacqueline Cavalcante. Looking for her first win not only in the LFA, but here in the U.S. as well.
Yeah, see, she's bouncing a little bit more now. There, nice jab. Oh,
beautiful combination from Lehner. Now letting her fist fly a little bit. She said
Her style is striking, but continuing the theme, she said, simply put, dog.
Yeah, Kat just has no answer for the tight clinch.
So far, she doesn't. You're right. And again, her coaches do not want her in this position. Trying to tell her to wrestle out, get away from her.
Yeah, Crowden was trying to lock her hands, but it's really tough when you're on the fence. Usually you can bounce off the cage to lock your hands.
Just reset in the center of the octagon. As we approach 30 to go, Lena punches her way in, but once again, Muay Thai clinch from Crowden and getting some good knees through the guard.
Yeah, I don't think Kat expected that because she was anticipating being able to kind of walk her down and just kind of be the enforcer in this match. And so far, she hasn't been.
Sneaky little spinning elbow from the German.
Nice takedown.
And some hammer fist to end the round. Big takedown from Melissa Crowden and finishes that first round with an exclamation point and some big strikes. Let's check out the highlights here, Cub, in that opening round. I mean,
yeah, like
Crowden,
I said,
going to work with those knees.
She keeps getting the tie clinch and getting to work, and Kat really does not like it, and she's showing it. You can't show your opponent that you don't like something that much, or they're going to keep going back to it. So she's kind of giving her the game plan. There's a nice spinning elbow. She's gritty. She's a veteran. She's been doing this for a long time. She's going to keep looking for ways to win. But that takedown right there by Crowden is really nice because it's the end of the round and you ended up on top. It's like, yeah, I'm creeping away with this. It's about to be mine real soon here.
Absolutely. We enter into the second round here in Dallas, Texas. Talking about the knees, both fighters throwing and landing. Lena going 6 of 7, and Crowden, she landed 9 knees out of 16 attempts. Strikes were pretty even in that first round. Lena outstruck Crowden 36 to 25.
So Crowden's tried that lead snap kick, and she told us yesterday that she was going to be looking for that head kick because she knows that Kat drops her right hand when she throws a jab.
Right.
So she's been trying to time it, and I think the later in the fight it gets, the higher likelihood she'll have of landing it.
Lena has that boxing background, 1-1 as a professional, coming off a decision loss in April. She has been doing martial arts and boxing since she was a teenager.
She's kind of just reacting, though. Like I said, she needs to be the bully. She needs to take... She's the one with more experience. She needs to go in there, march her down, and start dictating that. Like, I'm the veteran. I know how to fight this fight. And she really isn't doing that.
And again, you mentioned it earlier, Cub. I mean, Crowden having a lot of success in the clinch.
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised that Crowden isn't using more of her footwork, and she's being the bully. So, I mean, it shows some growth in her game. Obviously, that's what her coaches have been helping her with at her new gym.
We talked about the move to the Blitz Sports MMA. Jake Brennan, Haley Cowan for Melissa Crowden, originally from Alberta, now training down here in Waco, Texas. She said, "I just had to do it if I wanted to take my game up to the next level." She had trained with Haley before and called Haley Cowan the perfect training partner for her.
And I know what that's like. There's certain people that you just don't mesh with. There's good exchanges there. There's certain training partners that always hurt you. You know, you just kind of don't mesh. And there's certain training partners that are your go-to, and it's always smooth, and you guys get each other. So those are the kind of training partners you want to find and you want to keep around.
So key. Right now, Cub, very impressive performance by Melissa Crowden on the feet. very comfortable, great movement in the face of Catharina Lehner right now, showing a little bit of damage.
Yeah, it's like maybe she underestimated her a little bit. Kat thought that she was going to go in there, knew exactly what to do, and didn't really take into consideration that this is a whole new Croton, and she had that loss, and she's coming back, and she worked on that skill set, and it's a new version of her, and we're seeing the best version of her.
You know, and Croton was talking about that difficult loss to Cavalcante in the title fight and said, I just took away from it as a learning experience, knew I had to get better. That was part of the move as well. And we are seeing Melissa Croton version 2.0 here tonight.
For sure. She's got to be proud of herself looking back at this footage later. She's going to watch this and say, man, I look at all these things I did right. You know, look at some things that she may have not done so good and keep making those improvements. But, I mean, she definitely looks like a whole new version.
Yes, for sure. Now, listen. Kat Lehner is not done in this fight. She continues to press on and throw strikes and exchange. A little bit of blood trickling from the side of the eye. I mean, beautiful range and footwork and movement by Melissa Croton right now.
Yeah, sometimes, you know, fighters need to get hit a few times to wake up. You know, they're just kind of...
That was never really you, though, was it?
I've had a couple fights that I didn't start my best.
Mm.
You know, Jose Aldo definitely...
Okay.
Yeah, started off on a bad note. But I learned later in my career how to not let that happen as often.
Can't wait to see you back in the UFC Octagon. Good times coming off that huge win in the last fight.
Wow.
Going back into the clinch, throwing those knees.
See, she keeps going back to the things that were doing well for her, obviously.
Brilliant.
So,
yep.
I mean, it's showing that she has good fight IQ. She's learning as she's going in there. And then people need to know, when you throw those little snap kicks and they block it with one hand, you're still absorbing quite a bit of damage.
Well, as time is winding down here in the second, Melissa Croton once again ending this second round with a flurry. And, whoa, if there was a few seconds more on that clock, Melissa Croton may have just taken out Kat Lehner. What a second round for Croton. In the Elevation fight team, we first take a look at Melissa Croton.
She looks in control.
Yeah,
she's breathing. Obviously, she's a little tired, but she's not panicking. See, there's that kick. It's partially blocked, but you're still taking a good strike to the face, and that's going to rattle you. That's a nice blitz from Kat, sorry, and she needs to do more of that. And that's the right hand that I think caused the cut right there.
I think you're right.
Both of them
you
did the,
it. Yep.
The blitz.
Good call, Cub.
And that can be effective when you're trying to move forward. Sometimes you just got to blitz your way in.
Former LFA fighter Justin Wetzel in the corner of Kat Lehner, shouting instructions as we move on to the third round. And I think Kat Lehner is in some trouble. That face took some damage as Croton continues to tee off. Croton landing 39% of her strikes. She's thrown 145. Her knees have done a lot of damage. She is 15 of 24 landing with the knees thrown. See if Kat Lehner has an answer. She tries to switch things up. I mean, Cub, I thought that fight was over. And I think if there were a few seconds left on that clock, it would
be. Yeah, the ref fell over then. He was trying to get in there to make sure. He was getting his work in.
Oh, and the knees continue to land. Melissa Croton would love a finish. Wow, now on the back of Lehner.
This is a really good fight for her to kind of show off her skill set. She's getting to work in a lot of different places. You know, if I were her, I wouldn't waste too much energy here. Maybe disengage and get it back to the feet. You could tell those are hurting her.
Yes, they're hurting me. Watching in. Melissa Croton looking to end this fight here.
It's
early
close.
In the third. Continuing to dominate Kat Lehner. The end you feel is near, Cub.
Yeah, she's trying to get her back down, and then she's going to get back to the strikes, which is the right move.
Yes.
Bombs being dropped here at the factory tonight from Melissa Croton. Operating half guard. Kat Lehner's face is bloodied and bruised.
Yeah, Kat's just surviving right now at this point. She doesn't want to get finished. You know, she knows she's losing, but she's just waiting for an opportunity to get up.
And Lehner, a veteran fighter, 33 years old, as tough as they come. No quit in her. Showing incredible heart, but as we go past the midway point here in the third round, Melissa Croton in cruise control.
Yeah, Croton right now, she could just cruise this out to a victory, but she's got her right where she wants her. The UFC wants to see people go for finishes. They want to see aggression. They know, spend the 2 minutes trying to get her out of there. So we'll see how she's playing this out.
She's doing everything in her power to finish this fight. You hear some of the fans here in Dallas cheering for Kat. She has a big following. Oh, but Melissa Croton, that's going to do it. Good call and a good stoppage. Melissa Croton, victorious here in Dallas, Texas. Earning her first win inside the LFA Octagon. Quickly, Cub bounces back from that bantamweight title fight loss in April to score a dominant win tonight.
She's got to be excited. All right, here we go. Goes right back to the clinch. Like I said, good fight IQ. Go back to what was already, you know, helping you out in this whole fight. And those knees to the back, man, those are brutal. You could tell by her, by Kat reaching back and trying to block those. Those didn't feel good. And here's the finish. Too many unanswered shots. Kat just wasn't defending herself intelligently, and the ref stepped in. What a great victory for Melissa.
Melissa Scare Croton, wow. That's all I can say right now is wow. What a performance by the 32-year-old, originally from Crow's Nest Pass, Alberta, now with Jake Brennan and the team at Blitz Sports MMA. Very impressive performance. We're waiting. The doctors here ringside, cage side, are taking a close look at Kat Lehner. That was a dominant performance by Croton, who comes over to see how Lehner is doing. Beautiful sign of respect from those two. But a tough night inside the octagon for Lehner. Good to see her off the stool now, walking into the center of the octagon. Let's now get the official decision back inside to Mike Kendall.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Steve Armstrong calls a stop to the fight. 3 minutes, 20 seconds into the third round, declaring your winner by TKL, Melissa Scoden Croden.
Melissa Croton bounces back very quickly from the tough title defeat to Jacqueline Calvin-Conte, who with that win was one of our many fighters called up to the UFC. Melissa Cronin made a statement tonight.